أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. إن شاء الله if we can come close every time, إن شاء الله تقارب بإذن. نواصل الكلام في الفقه. We continue about the Islamic jurisprudence or أحكام from كتاب الرسالة الجامعة or translated as the fundamentals of Islam. Very concise introduction of the fiqh al-Imam al-Shafi'i. Amongst other things, we just taken the fiqh. Last time we talked about تكلمنا عن فروض الوضوء. ما المقصود بكلمة فروض? What do we mean when we say فروض or obligations of وضوء? It refers to أركان, the most essential things. التي إذا انتقض منها واحد, if one of them is missing, there's no وضوء. You have to remain the وضوء. كم فرائض الوضوء? لا. Six of them. Six of them based on the ayah. Based on the ayah, yes. What is the ayah? يا أيها الذين آمنوا or you who believe, and number six of Surah المائدة. إذا قمتم إلى الصلاة, when you stand up, about to make صلاة, فاغسلوا وجوهكم. So number one is ماشي نية. نية, we learn it from something else. اللي هو إنما الأعمال بالنيات. For anything you will need the نية. وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى. That's one. Number two, اغسلوا وجوهكم. Wash your face from where the hair normally grows up to under the lower jaw. And horizontally from ear to ear. وأيديكم إلى المرافق. And your hands or arms up to the elbows. So hands should be washed again after the face. Up to the elbows. And elbows are included. مع المرفق. إلى المرفقين اللي هو ما يسمونه بالكوع. And it's included as well. وامسحوا برؤوسكم. Number four is المسح. Wiping over the head. The least, even if it's three hair, is enough. According to Imam Shafi'i, wiping over that. وأرجلكم. And إيش? Number five. What do you do with the feet? غسل القدمين. Washing the feet. Up to where? The ankles. The ankles are?
Included.
Wash the ankles as well. So these are five. One is missing, which is?
Order.
At-tartib, order. Do that in this order. These are the essential. There are so many adab and sunan. There are so many extras. And that's not to say these are the only things to do whenever you choose. No. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, usually, almost all the time, he would do what we do. Start with washing the hands and then madmada, stinshaq, mouth, nose. That is sunan adab. But we have here muqaddimah basita. بعدين inshallah later we can talk about all the other details. طيب. قال فروض الوضوء ستة. الأول النية. الثاني غسل الوجه وحده من منابت وحده من منابت الشعر الرأسي إلى منتهى اللحيين. والذقن طولا وعرضا من الأذن إلى الأذن. الثالث غسل اليدين إلى المرفقين. الرابع مسح شيء من بشرة الرأس أو شعر في حده. الخامس غسل الرجلين مع الكعبين. السادس الترتيب على هذه الكيفية. طيب قال وإن كان عليه جنابة. If one is in a state of جنابة من مجامعة أو خروج مني, which is because of sexual intercourse or emission of sexual fluid mani, أو غيره لزمه غسل أو غسل جميع بدنه مع نية رفع الجنابة. If someone is in a state of janaba happens in two cases. State of janaba is if somebody has the husband-wife relationship, the intercourse, whether the mani comes out or not. The person becomes in a state of janaba and he has to have a full ghusl. Or the second, if the mani comes out, whether this is because of the intercourse or this is because of a wet dream, that is also a state of janaba. If the person is in this state, wudu will not be enough. What will be needed? Ghusl, full shower. And that we'll talk about later inshallah. طيب, today, quickly we talk about nawaqidul wudu. Or the nullifiers of wudu. What nullifies, what cancels, what ends the wudu? How many of them are out there? ستة also six of them. Six of them to make it easy. هذه الأشياء بقى نحفظها إخوان. We have to memorize these so we can especially the essential, the فروض. طيب نواقض الوضوء. Number one, الإمام الشافعي يقول ما خرج من السبيلين. Anything that comes out of the two outlets, the front or the back, anything that comes out of that, whether it's fluid, liquid, like somebody is peeing, or any kind of fluid, or it is hard, like the feces, عزكم الله. يبقى ما خرج من or ريح, or air, like, right? So like the gas coming out. ونقض الوضوء أو وينقض الوضوء الخارج من أحد السبيلين القبل أو الدبر على ما كان على أي صفة كان. Anything that comes out will make break the wudu. وينقض الوضوء number two زوال العقل بنوم أو غيره إلا نوم ممكن مقعدته أو مقعدته من الأرض. If somebody sleeps or generally speaking زوال العقل. زوال العقل. إذا زال عقل الإنسان خلاص انتهى. If the power of mind is gone for any reason, the person is not in a full mental control of himself or intellectual control, then the wudu is gone. Like sleeping. When somebody sleeps, you don't control. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال العين وكاء السهم فمن نام فليتوضأ. What do you mean العين? He said the eye or the conscious eye is the وكاء. الوكاء هو ما كان يربط به فم القربة. If you have a water skin back in the days, قربة فكر القربة حق كرها معروفة هنا. And then you tie the mouth of it, يربط به فم القربة. You tie هذا الوكاء أو صرة من ال they used to keep the money in these kind of bags or sacks, and in these days some of the perfume, some of the gifts that comes with this tie on the top is wika in Arabic. So the Prophet said the eye works like this wika for this state. So because once you sleep, you have no control, you don't know what happens after that. So whether you sleep, whether a person gets in coma, whether a person got drunk, والعياذ بالله, anything that removes the mind or the العقل يعني زوال العقل بسكر أو مرض, or somebody gets sick for any reason, something happened, he doesn't, all of that would remove the wudu. وينقض الوضوء مس قبل أو دبر من آدمي أو مس قبل أو دبر آدمي منه أو من غيره ببطن الكف وبطون الأصابع كبيرا كان أو صغيرا ولو ولده ولو ميتا. طيب, if somebody touches any private parts, whether it's his own or her own private parts or someone else's private parts, according to Imam Shafi'i, touching it with the skin of the inside of the palm, not with the bag. لأن المس في اللغة العربية مس. In English you say touch, this is touch, this is touch, this is touch. But mess in Arabic هو الجس بباطن الكف. It is to touch with باطن, with this area in here. So touching the private parts, whether the person's or someone else's, this will break the wall, even if he is a young person. وينقض الوضوء التقاء بشرتي رجل وامرأة كبيرين أجنبيين بلا حائل. If somebody touching from a man to a woman or from a woman to a man, قالوا المرأة التي تشتهى غالبا, not an adult but old enough, someone is old enough that there may be shahwa in there. If touching with any part except for the hair or the dhufr, that's not in Arabic, is not called mess or touching. Mess is by or lams in this case is by any part of the body or any part of the skin. So that will break the wudu according to Imam Shafi'i. الإمام أبو حنيفة عنده المس بشهوة أو بغير شهوة لا ينقض الوضوء. If a male touches a female, and by the way هذا لغير المحرمية. If a man let's say touches his mother or his sister or anybody that he cannot get married to. Anybody that he cannot get married, that's called what? Mahram. He is mahram for her, right? So if you touch that, that doesn't break the wudu. But if you touch any woman that you are already married or you can get married to, that's what we are talking about here. فالإمام أبو حنيفة عنده أي مس لا ينقض ولا لمس لا ينقض. No, doesn't break the wudu. Whether you have the shahwa, the desire or not. Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad, they will say you have to have, it will break the wudu, but then if you have the shahwa. Imam al-Shafi'i قال شهوة أو بغير شهوة أي لمس أو لا يمسه النساء. Then that will break the wudu. قال إلا غفرا أو شعرا أو سنا فلا ينقض. So these are the things that break the wudu. ما خرج من السبيلين, anything that comes from the front or the back, anything. القبل والضبر على مكان وزوال العقل. Somebody loses, got in coma or sleeps. One state that Imam Shafi'i said, قال إلا ممكن مقعدته. If somebody is like he slept while sitting down, like fully on the ground, there is no way physically that anything can come out. He cannot pass gas if he is standing straight. And ممكن مقعدته, where the bottom of that person is totally on the ground, where physically there is nothing that can come out, then he said in this case, he doesn't do the wudu. But generally speaking, if somebody sleeps, other than this position, he loses the wudu. Or getting coma or anything happens like that. زوال العقل بسكر أو مرض. Or if somebody touches the private parts, or somebody of himself or others, or somebody touches the opposite gender, somebody غير محرمية يعني, or she touches the man as well. In all of these cases, that will lead to the break of the wudu. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Any questions? About what?
The blood.
Okay.
You may turn it off.
I will break the wudu or not. In Imam Abu Hanifa, he said it will break the wudu. But I want to know about this.
For Imam Shafi'i?
You know, just we want to follow up the base, the reading, you know, within the Sahih. There's a first question and a second. For the mass?
خلينا بس نستيك وانا نسيك حتى تعالى. For Imam Shafi'i, لا ينقض الوضوء الفصد ولا الحجامة ولا خروج. Any blood that comes out, it does not break the wudu. Unless it comes, like anything else from where the person is, from the front or from the back. That's a different, sabilein, that's a different thing. But blood like that, they will have little variation if it's too much, or if it is انتقل من محلي, but generally speaking, for Imam Shafi'i, it does not break the wudu. Right? And again, that is meant to be a concise presentation. Otherwise, if we talk about the adilla, which Imam is quoting, what dalil, that's going to take long. Because I'm aware of the story, the person was praying, and then he got the arrow, and then the second arrow, and he was badly bleeding, right? So those who said, for Imam Shafi'i, that's going to be a dalil, because he was praying at night. And he continued. كان في حراسة المسلمين. He got the first shot, took it out. He was badly bleeding. So and he continued his salah, which means that the blood does not break the wudu. Second question, quickly, inshallah.
For the masih.
Masih, which masih?
Yeah, you told me this. Masih.
On the head?
No, for the masih. Khufayn.
We did not talk about masih khufayn yet.
No, it's not masih khufayn. It's masih.
Touch.
No, عقد الوضوء, which mess? Mess, you mean mess, touching?
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. So you told that if somebody
touches his own private parts or someone else's private parts,
yeah, so the wudu will break out. That's
according to Imam Shafi'i, yes.
Yes.
لأنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من مس ذكره فليتوضأ. Somebody touches his own private parts, he should make wudu. And وقاسوا على ذلك, and مش قاس على ذلك, the other side. He said it's the same thing. Yes. Any other question quickly?
Yeah, so
questions only in what we discussed.
Yeah. During khutbah in Jum'ah, I see sometimes some people, even me, sometimes that happened to me, sleep like this. So how about this one?
Like make sure you are sitting, and number two, don't sleep during the khutbah. You're not coming to sleep, Habib.
Alhamdulillah, I say it all, but it's not happening all the time. But I see some people. they are, you know,
wake them up.
Yeah. So it just like this.
So yeah, so make sure if somebody is sitting down, make sure that he's sitting down. Otherwise, the person is going to lose wudu.
No.
Right.
Yeah.
Wallahu a'lam. Now, لا ينقض الوضوء. لا ينقض الوضوء لا قي ولا عند الإمام الشافعي ولا أكل لحم الجزور ولا أكل ما مسته النار. If you eat something that's touched by fire, because some imams for them it's that, and many other things, none of that will break the wudu. So قي doesn't suffer some. Not the four imams of Qahqaha, if somebody in the Salah breaks the wudu, none of that will break the wudu. Only this list here will break the wudu for Imam Shafi'i. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. JazakumAllah khair wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Salawi